Welcome to the Firebird Introduction video. The Firebird application installer can be found on the flash drive under the Firebird folder. Extract the Firebird zip file by right-clicking on the file and selecting the Extract option in the menu. Then use the Extract button to continue the procedure. Once the file is extracted, use the setup.exe file in the extracted folder to start the installer. Use the Next button throughout the installer to finish installing the program and then close to exit the installer once completed. When you launch the Firebird Graphics Editor, you will be taken to the main program control page. Across the top, you can see the menu bar. The file drop-down on the menu bar has standard file controls that allow you to open your image files or to select a recently edited file. From here, you can choose to create a new Braille file from scratch or save your work or exit. If you have a PRN file, open it using Import PRN rather than Open. Now, the Firebird Graphic Editor can open a number of different standard image formats, such as JPEGs, GIFs, BMPs, and certain SVG files. These are all conventional graphic image files. Under Edit, you have your traditional undo and redo functions called undo source and redo source. The undo function will go all the way back to the beginning of the program being opened, and redo will go all the way forward to your last edit. Under Page Sizes, you can add a custom page size or edit in an existing page size. Image tools and image filters are both sets of tools used to make macro changes to your graphic. Image tools has options for grayscale, image sharpening, or increasing and decreasing contrast. Image filters has options for edge detection and other macro changes. Use these tools to edit your whole image before you start making finer edits. Under the Help drop-down, we have a general Help, Shortcuts, and an About Us page. Help is context-sensitive throughout the program, which means, for example, that if you want to know more about image tools, simply highlight the Image Tools menu, press F1, and it will take you directly to the Image Tools section of the Help Index. This is functional throughout the program. To the left, we have a section called the Source Image. This is where your graphic file will be displayed. To the right, we have a page image file display. This is where the dot pattern will appear. And down below, we have an image control box. In this section, you can select an embosser that is compatible with the Firebird application. We will select the APH PageBlaster. In the DPI setting drop-down, you can select the resolution of the final graphic image. The Paper Size drop-down is where you are able to select the paper you are using. For most images, we like to use 11.5 by 11. And finally, the Edit button in the Page Image section opens the second part of the Firebird application where you can edit the dots directly. Let's open an image. On the left is the original image, and on the right is Firebird's interpretation of the original in Braille dots. To make changes to this image, add Braille labels, or fix any issues with the conversion, press the Edit button, and that will bring up the editor. In this window, we again have the main toolbar across the top. File is your standard file and emboss utilities. Controls will allow you to select the text entry or 6-key entry to create Braille labels. Edit has cut, copy, paste, undo, and redo functions. The tools are drawing tools. They can be used to make lines, circles, and rectangles, much like you'd find in any graphic editor. Note that these are the same tools that are available over on the left as buttons. Fills offers several fill patterns that can be used when using the drawing tools. Pen width offers 1, 2, 3, or 4 dots wide. Dot intensity is used with embossers that have multiple dot heights. PageBlaster only has 1 dot height, so we will not be using this feature today. We finish the main top menu with the Help menu. The first thing we need to do on this graphic is to replace the print labels with Braille. To do so, select the Eraser tool and take out the representation of the print Y. Now, select the text label, and in the pop-up window, we want capital Y in Braille. And if you are using an ASCII key entry method, the capital letter sign is comma, which is .6 in the U.S. So we will do two commas and the letter Y. We will do the same for the X label. If you are using 6-key entry method and need to know what key to press to get a particular dot combination, you can search for 6-key label entry in the Help, and at the bottom you will find a graphic that shows that information. Other controls are the zoom controls to zoom in or out. You can also choose from the drop-down menu a specific zoom ratio. The button to the left of the zoom plus button will return the view to the original zoom level. To emboss your image, select Emboss in the File menu or click the printer icon on the top of the screen. In the printer window, select PageBlaster as a printer and click OK. For more information, visit us at aph.org/product/PageBlaster.